everybody. It's your friendly digital technology librarian, Christy, here. We are on the second Friday of April already, and as April happens to be Jazz Appreciation Month, I wanted to take this week and do a selection of recommendations all about films having to do with jazz music. I happen to be a huge, huge music fan, and I do love jazz, and I'm really hoping that you'll be able to find something within these recs that really speaks to you. I tried to do a really broad selection so that whether you're a huge jazz buff or if you're just sort of familiar vaguely with it but aren't really a huge fan, you'll still be able to find something that interests you. As with every single week, all of these recommendations are available to you completely for free with the use of your Mylan Berlin library card, and all of these recs will come from one of our three video services, which are Klevenet's Overdrive, Hoopla Digital, and Canopy. So without any further ado, I'm going to go ahead and dive right into those recs. Okay, my first recommendation comes to you from Klevenet's Overdrive, and it's for the full miniseries of Jazz, a Film by Ken Burns. Now, this originally aired on PBS, as do almost all of Burns's documentaries. He, if you're not familiar, is a ridiculously brilliant documentarian. He is incredibly thorough, always has a fascinating point of view, and with this particular work, he brings all of his best right to your screen. He essentially tells the entire story of jazz music. I mean, or at least at the very least, he does his absolute best to. And he frequently will describe jazz as the quintessential American art form. This miniseries is 10 parts. You can access all 10 episodes on Overdrive. And since Klevenet's Overdrive is one of those systems that doesn't limit you as far as how many checkouts you have per month, you can absolutely binge watch all 10 episodes. I know that when I rewatched this, I almost did. But it's truly a fascinating, fascinating documentary miniseries. Burns travels with jazz music from, say, the French Quarter in New Orleans to Lincoln Gardens in Chicago. He looks at, you know, the big names like Charlie Parker, Louis Armstrong, and he really does traverse everywhere that jazz is and was, and he really goes in depth about the people, which I really, really love, because I think that's one of those ways that his documentaries in particular really outshine so many others. He gives so much personality and so much weight to the importance of the people involved in whatever it is that he's covering. And with jazz especially, like, it's those musicians, it's those artists who made the art form so incredibly broad and so capable of speaking to so many people from so many different walks of life. Some of the other things that are really, really cool about this particular miniseries is that Burns manages to get his hands on tons of footage and photographs and other materials that have never, ever seen the light of day before. Probably privately held collections, things like that. And it's just fascinating to see, especially like the video footage that's never been aired before, never been shown to other people outside families and things like that. I mean, it just adds this whole layer to the jazz music that I'm familiar with. Because I definitely feel like I'm really invested in like the earlier jazz music as opposed to like contemporary jazz. And just when you think, oh, I've seen, like, I've read these books, I've seen these videos and films before, like, you come across things that, you know, are still out there, still waiting to be found. So this particular film documentary just does such a phenomenal job of giving personality to jazz as a thing. I think it would speak to both people who are already lovers of jazz music and people who are just really interested in music and history in particular. You have a lot of celebrities who also took part in this documentary as narrators and other voices that you'll definitely hear and be familiar with. People like Samuel L. Jackson, Delroy Lindo, Derek Jacobi, Harry Connick Jr. I mean, the list goes on. And having them sort of give voice to different eras and different people, it's definitely another element that adds color and personality to jazz in general. So again, whether or not you're super familiar with the genre, or you're just dabbling, or you're just interested in history, please check out Ken Burns Jazz. It's fantastic. 10 episodes, all available on CleveNuts Overdrive. All right, moving right along to our selections from Hoopla. The first recommendation I have from Hoopla is for a movie called Lowdown. Now, Lowdown is a biopic that follows the life of Joe Albany, who was a jazz pianist in the 60s and 70s, primarily. That's the era that he was really well known for. And the movie tracks a large swath of his life as a musician and as this really wonderful artist who also was just unfortunately like plagued by demons. He was a heroin addict and suffered greatly from that. But what this movie does is show how he was so much more than just this man who was troubled by this addiction. He also had this incredible relationship with his daughter, Amy, Amy Jo. And this movie is actually based on her memoir and the way she viewed her father, his troubles, his struggles. And it's a difficult watch just because it's always tough to watch someone falling so much. But watching the relationship unfold and seeing how the two actors, Amy Jo is played by Elle Fanning really beautifully. And Joe Albany is played by John Hawkes, who I think is one of the best actors out there. I've never seen him in something that I haven't thought he was utterly brilliant in. And it's just incredibly beautiful in spots and devastating in others. The production is really well done. You get that feel of, sort of seedy 1960s, 70s vibe, where things are slowing on a decline, kind of decaying situation. The production is as much a character as Amy Jo or Joe are. Like it's definitely a whole other level. So yeah, if you're looking for a film that will definitely move you, that will make you sad in parts, that will make you wish good things for certain characters, that will definitely like transport you to the 1970s, and that will have music that really speaks to you if you're a jazz fan, please do check out Lowdown. I'd not actually seen this film before putting together these recommendations, so it was totally new to me, and I thought it was really well done, and would strongly recommend it. So Lowdown, available on Hoopla. Now, my second Hoopla recommendation is for a film called Of Mind and Music. Now, this one is definitely like tug at your heartstrings, sentimental picture, but it's really lovely and well done. It follows this brilliant neurosurgeon who, after returning from a lecture course overseas, returns to discover his mother has succumbed to Alzheimer's disease. And this sort of overwhelming feeling of failure. I mean, he's a doctor who whose entire job has to do with fixing the brain. You know, and the fact that he couldn't save his mother, it definitely spurs him to look and ask questions about, like, the world in general. So, from the get-go of the film, he is trying to latch on to the relationship that he had with his mom, and one of the things that they shared is a love for music. So when he goes out into the world to try and recapture those feelings and emotions he shared with his mom with regard to music, he comes across this voice that he just is enthralled by. And at the time, I believe he's in the French Quarter. And it's just, like I said, it's just this, like, siren call for him. And once he gets to know this singer, he discovers that she is actually also suffering from Alzheimer's disease as well. And this, of course, spurs so much more going on. And you can tell, like, all of the different layers of how both situations are sort of combining for him. The loss of his mother and the slow decline of this voice that he fell in love with. And it's just one of those movies that really, really sort of grabs you and, like, pulls you into the entire sphere of everything. The acting is really, really well done. Joaquin de Almeida is the lead actor who plays Alvaro Cruz. He's the neurosurgeon. And the singer that he falls for the voice is a character named Una Vida, and that's Anjanou Ellis, I believe is how you say her name. I'm not 100% on that. I apologize in advance. But both of these actors just really sink into their roles, and it's just exquisite. Like, really, truly, it's such a good movie, and the music is extraordinary. It's another character itself. So you have obviously elements of drama, sentimentality, but there's also a little bit of a quest going on too. And I know that seems sort of weird in what's essentially a straightforward drama, but there's definitely a questing element. So if you're interested in a film that will definitely make you think and that will make you feel and that will force you to ask questions yourself, please check out Of Mind and Music. It's lovely and also available on Hoopla. Now, my last Hoopla recommendation is for a documentary film, and this one is called Chops, and it's one of those documentaries that I actually had not heard anything about. I don't know why I didn't. I mean, I think I've actually remember vaguely back when it first came out, heard, oh, there's this new documentary about jazz music and high school bands, but I don't think that I ever saw it before this last couple of weeks. Now, Chops follows this band from Florida as it prepares and competes in jazz at Lincoln Center, which is this big, massive, massive competition that sees high school jazz bands from across the country come and compete just to see who is the best. And it's really, really fascinating watching how these kids already grasp jazz music at a time when, you know, usually I feel jazz is like a difficult genre to sort of wrap your head around, both from just an enjoyment standpoint, but also from like a musical standpoint. Like, there's a lot of complicated notion within jazz, like the improvisation, like there's just a lot going on. And seeing how these kids, like they are kids, absolutely grasp that and love it and definitely see like the ties it had to musicians before them. And seeing how some of them grasp that more as time goes by, because all of that is absolutely followed, because we see this one particular high school as it travels toward this competition, you get to see things unfold. You get to see these kids grow. And it's fantastic. I really, really loved this. In addition to the kids, you meet other jazz musicians, of course. You see other schools and how they compete. There are some incredible performances in this. I mean, incredible. So I would 100% recommend this film for anyone who is even remotely interested in jazz music. Please, please, please check it out. I think it also really works well for people who are interested in films with a lot of competition, with questing going on. I think that's definitely something that would speak to you, even if you're not in it for the music. There's so much talk about like throwbacks and history that that's another element if you're into history, musical history especially. But yes, please watch Chops. This is absolutely fantastic documentary. You will love the kids that you meet. You will fall in love with the music. It's really, really incredible. So that's the last Hoopla recommendation. That's Chops. Please check it out. All right, my last two recommendations both, of course, come from our Canopy service. And the first of those is for the documentary film The Girls in the Band. Now, The Girls in the Band, I've actually watched a couple of times. I find this documentary really, really interesting. It's a critically acclaimed award winner, and it follows sort of the history of female jazz musicians within bands. From the 1930s all the way up until contemporary times. And it is one of those documentaries that will absolutely rile you up, I feel. It's kind of a hard watch in certain spots because it definitely will make you uncomfortable. The people talk about the difficulties they faced. Some of these women were women in all-girl bands. Some of these women are women who were in mixed gender bands, but they all had to face a great deal of discrimination. There was blatant racism and sexism, which I'm sure surprises absolutely no one. But when you hear the stories that they tell and the things that happen, I mean, when you hear from people exactly their experiences, it's like a whole other level, you know? And watching that and hearing it definitely gives this documentary a depth that I feel like just reading about these experiences, which I'm sure if you're a fan of the genre, you've probably read about these kinds of things before, but yeah, it definitely gives it a whole other layer. It talks so much about personal experience, and I think that's where I really got caught into the whole story. I loved hearing both the good and the bad. There are people who tell stories about really, really shady club owners, and it's funny on the surface, but absolutely terrifying underneath. And they talk about other musicians. They talk about things that they did while they were on the road. I mean, there's just a great deal of funny, fascinating, sad, exciting, anecdotal information in this that I think anyone who likes documentaries in general, regardless of what they're talking about, would enjoy this. It's a fun documentary in some ways, so don't think that it's going to be like all doom and gloom or anything like that. It's absolutely not. It definitely has a lot of fun within it, but it doesn't shy away from the difficult picture, you know? It also talks about the decline of female jazz musicians visibly. Like in the 1950s, it became something that you did not see very often, if at all. And it goes really in depth as to why, like the theories about why that happened to be. So yeah, if you are interested in women's studies, if you're interested obviously in jazz, if you are curious about history, This is a really, really good, solid documentary. I mean, really just all around, this one is a good one to check out. So The Girls in the Band, available on Canopy. Now, my very last recommendation is for the film Chico and Rita, and this is one of those movies that I absolutely adore. It is a Spanish language animated feature, so that it does have English subtitles. Please don't mind that. I never recommend anything just to recommend it as far as foreign language films go. Totally worth the subtitles and the extra effort. Chico and Rita is from the Oscar award-winning director Fernando Trueba. He did Belle Epoque and Calle 54. And the look of this animated feature is ridiculous. I absolutely love this style of art, and it's done by Javier Mariscal. And as a team, these two, I don't know that I've been as affected by an animated film in a long while. Chico and Rita, there's just something about it. And this one is definitely not made for kids. This is a grown-up film. It just happens to be animated. And I think that the animation actually is really important to the story that they're telling. It lends a little bit of fantasy and flair to this very legit storyline. It's 1940s Cuba. A young piano player meets a beautiful singer, and many things ensue. They are definitely on a quest for success. You see so many different settings, you hear so much extraordinary music. God, the music is so good in this. And it's just a fantastic, fantastic film. If you like animation at all, please check this out. If you like art at all, please check this out. It is visually stunning. It's got a phenomenal soundtrack, and the storyline will really catch you. If you like romance, if you like history, if you like drama, Chico and Rita, please, please, please check it out. It was nominated for Best Animated P Picture at the Academy Awards, and it did, in fact, win Best Animated Film at the Goyas. So, definitely has a great pedigree behind it. So, again, Chico and Rita, fantastic film, highly recommended. Now, with that is my final rec for this week. As always, if you have recommendations of your own, please, please, please feel free to comment and share them. I always like getting recommendations. I love finding films that I otherwise would not have if I didn't hear from you. If you have any requests for future themes, please comment and leave a note about those as well. So with that, I am going to go ahead and bring this video to a close. As always, thank you so much for joining me this week. And I will see you soon. Bye-bye.